When I was about 9 years old, I was at primary school and we had to do a concert, and the teacher was looking for someone that could do some basic dance move, and that was the birthing of my career. I got up and did a few moves and I became the star of that show. So that was my first taste of being in front of an audience and being in the spotlight, which I just absolutely loved. The challenges from a dancing point of view, which I found enticing and kept me going, was the fact that I couldn't do it. And that really irritated me. So I had to keep striving to perfect this art form and being able to do the steps that they were asking me to do. So that just inspired me just to keep going and coming back and trying and trying and trying again. And that motivation and that discipline and focus of trying to perfect the step led me to having a career as a professional dancer. So I matriculated from a school that focused on ballet as a subject, and I joined Pack Ballet, which was then the top company in South Africa. And I worked my way through the rankings and ultimately became a principal with the company. And again, I had the most amazing career of working with such talented dancers and choreographers from all around the world, actually. And through the years, I was the ballet master and then was fortunate enough to take on the role as the artistic director, which I currently run now with Joburg Ballet. So as we stand and speak today, I'm truly blessed to be the artistic director of Joburg Ballet, the top company in South Africa. Being the artistic director of Joburg Ballet, I love being on the floor. I love working with the dancers. I think maybe because I can relate to where they're coming from, so I have an understanding of what they're going through when they're physically on the dance floor. And then being in the role of sitting in an audience and actually watching it all come together and seeing them achieve their dreams of becoming an artist on stage. And I get carried away in their story and their artistry and their magic of what they're doing. So that's really, really special for me. You know, we're facing problems in South Africa with funding, and I think as a company and internationally, I think all top companies are facing the same problems of showing transformation within their companies and funding to be able to fulfill that and to follow through with those the dreams. We have amazing talent in our schools that we're working with now. So as much as it's a challenge to see the transformation coming through into the company and finding the funding, I really feel positive about Joburg Ballet and the support that we have from the city of Joburg and our audiences who are continuously coming to the ballet and supporting this wonderful company. You know, as I'm trying to promote ballet as a sport, because I think audiences don't realize just how physical it is, just similar to our top sports players. And you know, for a sports team, even a golfer, you've got to have that perfect pitch, you've got to have the perfect ground, you've got to have the perfect course in order to be able to execute the perfect game that you're wanting to play. Similarly with the dancers, they have to have a perfect dance floor in order for them to enhance and improve on their technique. We have gone through a phase within the company where our mats were incredibly slippery and the dancers were being hindered because they were so scared to push themselves to the limit in case they fell, they slipped, they went over on their ankle. Performing big pas de deux when you've got to run into your partner and execute big jumps, they were hesitant on doing it. So I definitely feel that the perfect floor is going to make the perfect dancer, because it hinders them in progressing if they've got to be aware of what the floor is like. In 2004, we came across to the Joburg Theatre where they had built these state-of-the-art studios for us. And in that process, we had been questioned about what mats are we going to be using on our floors. And that was when I was first introduced to finding out about Harlequin, the state-of-the-art flooring. And I'm embarrassed to say at the time, we actually financially couldn't afford to commit to these incredible mats. So it's been a long journey, and I'm thrilled to say that we are finally at a place now in 2020 where we are fortunate enough to have the Harlequin Cascade state-of-the-art mats now being used by Joburg Ballet. And it's a thrill that we can actually say that we have come from being at a level here to now using these amazing mats where most top companies around the world are actually using. The dancers absolutely love the floors. I'm thrilled to see what the level of the company is going to go to next with these amazing mats. Joburg Ballet strives to introduce new audiences continually because without our audiences, this art form is going to die. And I think it starts with our youth. We've got to start showing them what an amazing art form this is. Whether they become full-time professional dancers or not, they are our future audiences. So Joburg Ballet strives to continue inform, include, and try and, I don't want to say educate, but give all dancers, young and old, an opportunity to be a part of the Joburg Ballet family. South Africans are really embracing this amazing art form, and we're finding that there are a lot more teachers, a lot more studios that are out there. The teachers are becoming aware of the importance of good flooring, which includes these Harlequin mats. Joburg Ballet has some exciting plans going forward. We have amazing guest artists that are joining the company to come and perform with us. We are working with our schools. We are wanting to become more inclusive with them so that they become a part of our productions, so that all the wheels contributing to Joburg Ballet are working cohesively to make sure that this incredible art form continues for years to come, and that our audiences are inspired, motivated, and want to become a part of our family.